Having just returned from the New York climate convergence, I'm freshly aware that at this crucial time, when we have just a few decades to avert the worst of the catastrophic effects of climate change, how the CPUC regulates monopoly utilities is increasingly critical. That's why the pattern of corruption we've witnessed is even more disastrous. From collusion with PG&E regarding the horrendous disaster at San Bruno, to colluding with PG&E regarding spying on the ratepayers, objecting to forced installation of harmful smart meters, to colluding with Southern California Edison over who pays for their terrible management of San Onofre, the pattern of corruption is clear. But I was still shocked to find out that from a reliable source, a former CPUC commission president, that as my dear friend and colleague, Barbara George, was dying, her compensation was deliberately withheld, though people at the commission knew she needed the money for her cancer treatment. After friends and lawmakers intervened, the check was finally released, but Barbara had already died. Today I stand with both the dismayed public and your CPUC staffers who are calling for a commission that they can be proud to work for. Corruption and climate crisis, aging nuclear reactors, hazardous wireless meters, and natural gas lines don't mix.